Hello there, people of that YouTube. So today we are going to talk about, I think it's Breaker, a big Breaker. Well, it's this thing here. There will be a link down below to the website and the wiki here. And this is a newest. Well, it's 3 years old, but it's a really, really interesting browser that a viewer made me aware of, so I will just call it Breaker. Breaker is a free and open source web browser currently in development by Blue Link Labs. Breaker peer-to-peer technology allows users to self-publish website and web apps directly from the browser without the need to set up and administrate a separate web server or host their content on a third-party server. All files and websites are transferred using that data distribution tool, a hypermedia peer-to-peer protocol which allow files to be shared and hosted by several users. The browser also supports HTTP protocol to connect to traditional servers, and it's built up on the Electron framework and therefore use Chromium browser as a reference for web pages. So what this is basically the Torrent version of a web. That's not the right way to say it. It allows you to host websites on your system, on your physical hardware, without needing to have a server running in the cloud, or you know, without or have a server running on your system. And it's using peer-to-peer, and peer-to-peer is basically, think about torrents, you know. You go download a torrent and you take bits and pieces from people that have those bits and pieces, and you also upload bits and pieces to other people that need those bits and pieces. It's basically, you have some puzzles, you know, you need to make a big puzzle, and you have some of the pieces, they have some other pieces, and together you make a puzzle. You know, you get a picture out of it. I hope that makes any sense. It's kind of like decentralized in some way, because you host it on your end and blah 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 and all that. It do depend that your ISP allow you to use those protocol and to have a really, really active connection. In some countries, they are not that happy with you sending and receiving data 24/7, especially if it's a large quantity of data. Here in Denmark, we don't have so much problems with it. Here it says here, file stored in a local folder can be published as a .dat website. So think of it a little bit like you right click on an icon and click share. That's kind of like, you know, the 10-foot view of it, and then you share that website and you have your own website. If you go in here and we have a look at it here, it seems all cool and fancy and dancy and all of that. The problem is that decentralized technologies have been around for a long, long, long time. There have been many companies trying to decentralize media, hosting and stuff like that, and it don't seem to be taking off for some reason. Like a library, you can call that a decentralized or peer-to-peer technology alternative to YouTube. That's not that big. We had something called DLive, which was a live streaming service that also was a decentralized peer-to-peer live streaming service. I think it was peer-to-peer. I could be mistaken there, by the way. But again, I could be talking out of my ass, but I think it was. Some of them succeed to some extent, but a lot of them don't. And it's open source, it's MIT license, which some people say, oh, MIT is not real freedom, open source is real freedom. I don't want to go into that debate. It's Windows, Mac OS, and Linux available. How do I feel about this? It's a gimmick. It's a fun gimmick. It's a really, really fun gimmick. I really, really don't have a strong opinion about it. Here's a little bit of how peer-to-peer network works over a network based on a traditional network. So this is like how websites will be accessed from around the world on a DAT or on this on Breaker. And this is where traditional would be accessed. So this could be an Apache server in here in the middle, and then you access the GoDaddy or WordPress or server or something like that, and then you access it from there. I like that they are fiddling around with it. I've just never been a fan of this peer-to-peer things. I'm not a fan of it in gaming. There's a lot of lag and shit like that. I'm not a fan of it from a content creator. I'm not a fan of it from a web's hosting site. Like, I'm just not a fan of it. So I see this as it's a nice technology. It's a nice proving ground. It could have some uses, but I don't think that let's say Microsoft will start to use this or IBM, and they have too many critical services that they need to maintain, or critical websites that this makes no sense for, like a CNN website and stuff like that. For you at home, yeah, why not? It seems to be making it easy for you to make a website and share it. Why not? But if you want to be the next YouTuber, you want to host a cooking recipe site and stuff like that, that you want, or a blog for that matter, that you want a lot of people to access, I think you will still be better suited with a separate website services. I have probably forgot something. I probably missed something. It probably is better than I'm saying. I just don't think that this is the next big thing. It's an interesting concept. It's worth looking into. I just don't, like, from my experience with peer-to-peer technologies in the past, and I always look at the past to predict the future, because that's mostly how it's going to go, unless they are doing something groundbreaking, and they're not doing anything groundbreaking here, to be honest. And everything I've seen with peer-to-peer has just been a niche, so take it as you will. See you later. Bye-bye.